You're listening to KACL 780 on your AM dial. This is Dr. Frasier Crane. All our lines are open, so please give us a call.
I'm just sitting here waiting. Hey, Seattle, come on, I know you're out there. Hey, look, I realize it's a sunny day, but on all those rainy days, I was there for you. Well, all right then, if that's the way you want it, you leave me no recourse. When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza, that seems to have gotten you going there. Okay, all right then. I knew you were out there.
Okay, Roz, who do we have?
We have Gary from Issaquah
on line two. He and his wife had a big fight.
Sorry to hear that, Gary. I'm listening.
Well, you see, Dr. Crane, my wife's hell-bent on going to Italy this year.
Italia. The rolling hills of Toscana. The art of Firenze. The passion that is Venezia.
Yeah, well, anyway... I like taking vacation as much as the next guy. But I say if we dip into our savings, the first thing we should buy is a new sump pump for the basement. At least with
that... Oh, listen, Gary, let me just stop you right there. I'm afraid I'm going to have to side with your wife on this one.
But the trip to Italy costs $1,800, and that doesn't include the splendors of the Vatican package.
Gary, there is more to life than sump pumps. Whatever happened to feeding our souls? Look, for example...
I recently purchased a painting by one of this country's premier artists.
Oh, it's not important who. Well, it's Seattle's own Martha Paxton, but... practical? No, but ever since acquiring that painting, I look at it every day, and there's not a moment when I do that I'm not uplifted by its beauty. So, Gary, go to Italy. Bring back a suitcase full of memories. Will you do that?
I still think I should get the sump pump.
Well, then, yes, Gary, you should get the sump pump. We'll be right back after this news break.
Ross, just what is a sump pump?
If you need one, you'll know. Listen, do you really own a Paxton, or were you just blowing sunshine up old Gary's skirt?
Yes, indeed, I do own a Paxton.
Well, you'll be happy to know she's on line three.
Ross, she's the preeminent neophobist of the 20th century. How could you put her on hold?
Well, the phone rang. I pushed the little button.
Yes, hello, Miss Paxton. Oh, I'm so sorry to have kept you waiting. Well, thank you. Yes, oh, I'm very flattered that you listened to my little show. Yes, oh, well, yes, I meant every word. Oh, that's lovely. I'd like to meet you, too, sometime. As a matter of fact, I'm having a few friends over for a little gathering this Friday night for some cocktails and such. And, well, I suppose you're far too... You would? Well, oh, that's marvelous. Well, all right. That's the Elliott Bay Towers on the counterbalance. Around 7 is just fine. And, well, I'll see you then. Ciao.
I didn't know you're having a cocktail party.
That makes two of us.
Well, my theory on death is, first you whisk down a long dark tunnel towards a beautiful white light. You suddenly get all the jokes you never got before. You let out a little chuckle and then you die.
That's a delightful story, Daphne. But, you know, I think the toast points need replenishing.
Be right on it.
Enchanting. Just enchanting.
My God, Niles, why is no one eating the mousseline of duck? Oh, you mangy little cur!
Now we know why.
Oh, Niles, the dog is eating the food. The pianist is too intrusive. The Pinot Noir is far too stagey. It's 7:05, and Martha isn't even here yet.
I'm not going to have to sedate you, am I?
No, I'm just a bit on edge. I want everything to be so perfect. By the way, where's Maris? I haven't seen her all night.
She's on your bed.
My bed?
Yes, she's asleep under the guests' coats. She exhausts easily under the pressure to be interesting.
She's supposed to be looking after Dad. That's the only reason you're here, remember?
Dad is in the bathroom. Don't worry.
Well,